Hi guys, today being the World Mental Health Day, we GoScalers have decided to do a short video on mental health and expressing the views around it and also how this pandemic situation and remote working has affected it. Let's see what each one of us have to say.
Hi everybody. So for me, mental health awareness is about not keeping things closed inside myself. So whenever I feel like something is bothering me or there is something that I wanted to take out, I generally speak to any of my friends or colleagues or maybe family or anybody who is close to me. I think earlier it was easy as we keep meeting our friends, we keep meeting our family, but after COVID-19, once we went remote, one of the practices that we did was, and I think I'm speaking about not just me but entire, I'll say me and my family and friends, that we keep speaking to each other. Like, it was very, very regular. Although we were not able to meet per se, but we were quite connected, and people had sessions where they opened up about their problems or things that were bothering us.
Mental health is super crucial, guys. So to excel in the current situation, it's like a CPU of the computer. If it is not working well, you'll not be able to excel well in your life. So super, super crucial. Especially in COVID situation, so what happened is that we all have lost our routines, which was very, you know, tied up with the office routine, and because of the remote work, we are not able to do those things. So what I would suggest is that reach out to your friends for the help. It's not a stigma at all. Talk to your friends, make a social circle as much as possible, and that is super important, right? So don't hesitate in taking help. I think that is super crucial, right? So in this tough situation, I think mutual coordination between people is very important for us to, you know, come out of this very well.
For me, mental health is my personal well-being. Now, people might ask, what is personal well-being? So for me, personal well-being is when I know I'm able to take care of myself, when I'm able to understand and manage my, you know, complexities and stress, when I'm able to manage my physical, social and emotional well-being.
Mental health, according to me, is basically the current state of mind which influences your choices, decisions and reactions. Well, the current state of work, I mean the remote work, is basically blurred the line between work-life balance. You know, you have certain challenges at work, you face certain problems, your colleagues are there to help you out, but with this current scenario, you are on your own. I mean, it has its upsides, but then again, the downsides, you can't overlook it.
Hello everyone, I'm Kritika Singh. So this is a Mental Health Awareness Week, but with a difference. With the country under lockdown, health and social services under pressure, we are left with not so many options to keep our mental health well. But remote working has helped us a lot in this critical situation, as we are working but at the same time we are staying with our families. Now we have a good opportunity to share our problems, talk to them, share our thoughts, know them well. So utilize it well, talk to them, and stick around guys, we all will get through this together.
Hello guys, mental health is the most widely discussed topic nowadays, and it has become even more relevant in this uncertain time. According to me, a mentally healthy mind is something that has a counterbalance to every extreme emotion. If a person can tackle these extreme emotions, I think that is the most important characteristic of a mentally healthy mind. Disruption caused by this COVID-19 has made it very clear that finding this locus of counterbalance within is the most important thing. So wish you and your family a very good health.
So what is a good mental health according to you? So for me, which is something which keeps you engaging. Okay, so for me, something like, I love cooking, I love going out for long drives, having some quality time with my friends and families, going out for some workout. This always keeps me kind of motivating and engaging, which keeps, okay. So this is which I love it, and always keeps my mind in my kind of healthy state. Okay, and number two, it's kind of effects of COVID-19 and on remote working. So basically, it always gives you a line on a professional and a personal life on the early days. But as I told, always engage yourself with the things you love. Okay, like something cooking or maybe working out, small thing, which also gives you motivating to for the next day to work hard.
Mental health is the behavioral or psychological well-being of a person. So we know that India has world's largest population, but did we know that India has world's largest population in unipolar depressive disorder? Like irrespective of age, there are people who suffer from anxiety, depression, schizophrenia, and coronavirus or COVID-19 crisis has led to an increase of these cases. There's domestic abuse, there's substance abuse, there's depression, anxiety, and I think we as a society should stop stigmatizing mental illness, and our system should take steps to provide the help to the people who are vulnerable.
I want to share my views on mental health and work from home. Obviously, mental health issues is a serious problem which most of us are shy to talk about it. Do understand it should be spoken out, because it doesn't affect you alone but also your surroundings. The whole bubble is what I'm talking about. Do reach out for help if needed. We are here to help you, not to judge you.
Hello everyone, this is Meghana. Mental health, according to me, is taking care of our minds. Being happy, thinking positive, and staying motivated is what it means to be being mentally healthy. Due to corona, all these went for a toss in my life. So what I would like to suggest everyone is that taking care of your mental health is as important as taking care of your physical health. So make sure you do more things that will make you happy, that will keep you positive and motivated. Thank you.
Hey guys, this is Anand here. I'm going to speak few words about mental health and how remote work is affecting mental health. So according to me, mental health is being myself and to have a peaceful mind and to spend a quality time with family and friends, and also simultaneously doing my best at my workplace. So which is, we can say it as a perfect harmonic work and home. And how remote work is affecting mental health, I personally feel working remotely does increase mental stress, because we have to be confined within our home as we are at the risk of getting infection, which is like a mental fatigue, and we have to also help in our home in few household things, so which is rather stressful at times. So I feel sometimes remote work does increase our mental fatigue and stressful. Yeah, that's all about mental health for myself.
Mental health for me starts with self-awareness. Having an understanding about what kind of thoughts and feelings I'm having that are influencing these emotions. It helps me in understanding and rationalizing my thought pattern. It helps me in tackling these emotions in a better manner, because now I understand the cause behind it.
Mental health is having the humility to ask yourself, do I need help? Especially during this pandemic, the most common issue people face is anxiety. It's difficult not to feel anxious during this particular time, like it's spreading from person to person, contagious like the virus behind it. It's frightening, it manifests in new ways every day, but even so, it's not bigger than me, and it's not bigger than you, as simple as that.
So, one of the major lifestyle changes that came as a result of this pandemic was remote working. Remote working is nothing but working from home, which is our comfort zone. So why the stress surrounding it? I think this stress is just the byproduct of the anxiousness and the nervousness that we had around about the situation, because we were not ready for it. We never thought of something like this would happen to any of us. Just when we were coming to terms with this pandemic and hoping for a permanent solution, I think this came in as a huge blow to all of us. Day in and day out, we saw people being laid off and lot of negativity surrounding the situation, which is quite common. I think that's where mental health comes into picture. Maintaining a healthy mental life is very important because it also has an effect on the way you lead your life and your physical health as well. Mental health is basically, being able to understand what is happening within you, your emotions, your thought processes and your feelings, and being able to effectively communicate it with people around you or who are close to you. I think a lot of us, fail to do so because we ourselves don't know what we are going through. And it's very important to, learn to understand that. I hope this World Mental Health Day, we are able to create awareness about the same and also remove the stigma surrounding mental health and reaching out for help, seeking help, reaching out to people and seeking help or helping people with mental illness. I hope all of you are able to find that strength and reach out to right people at the right time. We are all in this together and hope we'll all be out of this as soon as possible.